Yo, what's up everybody? Good morning everyone around the world, especially those people out of their country to go to job to another country, which is what we call in the Philippines OFW or Overseas Filipino Workers. I'm gonna show you for this video, no? For today's video, I'm gonna share to you my life experience on board. Most of all, I'm gonna teach you and explain to you my motivational video when it comes to my job as a fitter, welder, or machinist on board a vessel, especially here in international vessel. Once again, my name is Mandirigmang Marino, and this is my legacy, this is my blog. Welcome to my channel. Let's go. Hold up. So in that video, as you can see, that is the old reducer pipe with two flanges. So I cut one by one, okay, the plans, and then the scrap of that plans, reducer and pipes, angle bars, etc., we did not throw it through the sea or in the water because that is against in our regulation as per MLC, at the same time marine pollution or MARPOL, against in the MARPOL regulation. So if someone of your crew or your officer in the ship see what happened, for example, you throw in the sea garbage, this scrap metal, etc., and then they take a photo with you, and then after the port, maybe you go to jail. Worst case scenario, you go to jail or you not rehire in your company. So that's sad. So beware all of you as a seafarer. You need to follow the rules and regulation of the MLC, of the MARPOL Consolidated 1-6. Some of the training included this kind of situation. So you see that I put it in the push cart so that I can move to the forecastle to keep it there to the forecastle, and then when we reach or arrive in the port, some of the garbage there, plastic can, etc., captain email to the company to land this scrap metal and other garbage in the ship so that we are safe for any problem for the authority, okay? Especially those material things in danger to the sea or chemical to damage the corals and the fish and the other elements, animals, mammals, whatsoever inside the sea, because you know we love to eat the fresh fish, so that we cannot destroy it. For that video, I show you a lot of flanges, square flanges also as well, because that square flanges is from hydraulic pipe located in the deck, okay? So thank you for watching this video. You see that I planning to move to the forecastle through this postcard, and then I keep it there until we reach the port. So I put it this the other side. This one is okay. I will sign okay, ready to replacing too late machines. So as you can see, there are so many of flanges and different sizes. So must watch this video because you know the late machine is small or medium type we have on board, so that how can you put to the chuck of the late machine this kind of flanges oversize. So you can learn to me in this video what I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to do for this video, this is important, okay, because how can you recondition and replacing these flanges if your late machine is small or medium size, the chuck cannot enter the flanges, you cannot recondition. So you must watch this video. Thank you for watching once again. This is Mandirigmang Marino, and this is my vlog and legacy. So this video is very long. As you can see, the size is 127 millimeter and outside this whole plans, and then the plunges is about 100, I think, more or less, I think 220, more or less 220. Okay, you can see that I put it in the late machine so that we can replace. So I'm gonna show you this to this video how it would happen. I can manage to replace these flanges. Okay, you see, just like new again, brand new. So that is the skills of your hand and the other hand of the machinist and the fitter on the ship, so that we can easy to work whatever chief engineer wants, or chief engineer give us job order, chief mate, captain, second engineer, whatsoever, any official can okay, that is the oversize. Okay, this one is not okay. So okay, you see that the chuck is very small and then the plans is very big. So how can you put it in the chuck, the plans very big? So I'm gonna show you to this video, so you must watch and learn also. Okay, this plans is not so big, so that you can wait until the video is going to show you the big plunges, and I put it the what we call our discarte, or simplify being as a mindset, you know what I'm saying. So I'm sorry for my English, because you know I am a Filipino, so that my English is not fluent and then not accurate. I hope you can understand me. So I'm trying to say, or what I'm trying to say right now is I explain to you what is my mind, what I'm doing right now, because some of my viewers and subscribers requested to me to what we call to say it, requested to give some what we call this, wait a moment, they said, sir, can you translate to the English or dub to the English, how can I do that? So that's why right now this vlog is I will try it to explain to you in English, not fluently, but you know, you can only realize that what I'm talking about is if you are a fitter or machinist, you know what I'm saying, and you can understand right now what I'm talking about. You see, very clean. So listen guys, for my opinion, I cannot put the round silker, the three circle in the plans. Every time I replace the plans, I cannot put it in the plans, you know what I'm saying. Some of the machinists can put it the round three round late machine, or three round what we call this, three round line. So that's it, I cannot put it the three round line in the plans, because some of the engineers, or I'm put it gasket in the plan. So what is the purpose of this tree line anyway? No problem if the plants is brand new. So if the plants is brand new, there is a tree line in the plants, in the base of the plants, and then you can put it the gasket so that the gasket cannot release. Okay, that is my opinion, and that is my explanation to you. That's why I cannot put it this tree lines in the base of the plants. So as you can see, very big. How can you put the very big oversized plants in the chuck if your late machine is too small? What we call it, oversized. You see that? What I'm going to do in the video, you see? Must watch this video because this is not very dangerous for me, huh? I don't know if somebody or someone make this job and copying my job as well. I'm gonna teach you slowly, okay? So you must watch first, and then from the moment I put it these plants, I'm testing slowly to minimal the vibration. You see? Can you see that? You see? You see on the back? I put it the small plants and I welded, spot weld 4 times, okay? Front, back, side by side, and then make strong. You need to center the plants, the big plants to small plants, on the center, and then weld, and then put it to the chuck, okay, to the lathe machine, so that you can replace the old flanges. Okay, you see, I'm testing only. So if you if you see and the hold the vibration of the lathe machine, you need to stop, you need to push button or push, because this one is automatic, you know, our lathe machine everywhere in the ship, anywhere in the ship, especially new brand new ship and model vessel, the lathe machine is automatic. You can put step on the down, so automatically stop just like that. You see, I'm trying to hold and touch if the replace is okay. So I'm doing good on this video, so not bad. Be careful, because you know, sometimes if you are not professional to do this kind of job, to do this kind of replacing in the oversized flanges, maybe you accidentally destroy your chuck or your lathe machine as well. And then sometimes the worst case scenario is you destroy the tool bit. You need a lot of tool bit if you not capable to do this job. Okay guys, I explain it to you not fluently. Yes, you see that it at the back, you see, I put it the plants, small plants, so that I can manage to replace this one. Okay, until the hole only, I cannot put it all replace, because the lathe machine is small, cannot touch all of the base of the plants, the big plants. You see, this one also, I put it the small flanges and then weld. Center, you need to center. You need to center the plants. You see? Center, okay guys, center. Same like this, yes? You can watch the video. You see? I explain it to the video. Okay. So this is very important, guys. This is dangerous, okay? This is not advisable to everyone on board as a fitter or as a welder or machinist. If your mindset or if your feeling, this is dangerous for you, don't try it. Please don't try it, because this kind of job, okay? I show my time, 4:45, so that this one is I will continue tomorrow. But my blog explanation to you is continue as well. So I explain to you, if you are not a professional and you cannot do this kind of job, because this job I will do every time. This is my first time, this job. No, there's a lot of time. There's a lot of company I will go to before. And then the same job, I will replace these plunges and square plunges as well. So many times. That's why this video is maybe that time when I first time do that job. Also, I was nervous, you know, feeling nervous because maybe it's broken, the lathe machine. I broke my lathe machine, so that right now this is not the first time. This is so many times I trying to replace the oversized plunge in the lathe machine. So thank you for watching my video once again. Mandirigmang Marino, Filipino of course, and shout out to the viewers, subscribers from Indian, our friend Indiano, of course, as well in the Brazil. There's a lot of you see electrician watching me there. Electrician also is a Filipino. Okay guys, I'm gonna tell you, no, I'm gonna inform you that this ship right now is a full crew Filipino. Our principal is a Greek company. A lot of the Greek company, for your information, lot of Greek company all over the world, especially in the Philippines, manning agency, only Filipino. No offense, my friend, our principals, no offense. Only Filipino crew, Greek ones, you know, you can understand that. Every Greek company in the Philippines, they only like to hire as a seaman is Filipino. Some of the time, there's a lot of mixed crew also as well. Filipino, Montenegro, Romanian as well. Just like that. Montenegro and Romanian, Filipino, just like that. But from my previous company and TSM, TSM Singapore, principal Indian, and other is TSM Germany, the principal is German. That ship is mixed. My captain is Egyptian, and then my chief engineer is Russian, and electrician is Ukrainian. So in German company, they don't want a full crew, they want a mixed crew, and then they manage by foreign official, captain Egyptian, just like that, or captain Poland, captain European, just like that. Because you know what, maybe more or less 15 years I'm on board the vessel, not too long, but before I'm a seafarer, before I become a seaman or a seafarer, my previous background experience as a welder in Japan, as a shipyard welder in Japan, you know what I'm saying? And then I learned a lot of specialty skills we cannot find in the Philippines, we cannot find in the ship. The skills I'm hold until now is a very, very high quality, you know? When it comes to job of the fitter in the shipyard, very, very skills and very quality job. That's why I'm always trying and apply to all my ship when I'm embark in the vessel. That's why until right now I am safe, and my colleagues also is safe. Sometimes other official not follow the rules, the regulation, the safety protocol, but I insist them not do this and not do that, because very dangerous for you, for our safety, and also for our ship and our company. I'm not a company man. Who am I? I'm only a Peter. I'm only a ordinary crew in the ship. But in my experience, my previous experience, when it comes to the safety of myself, the company, and other people around me, I will teach them and I will comply the rules and regulation, the safety of the ship, because I'm also a ratings, I'm a fitter, and before that I'm a welder, so that I apply what I'm learned and my past and previous experience, my friend. You know what I'm saying to you? That's why I'm become a motivator of my Filipino what we call this Filipino brothers. I am a Kuya Andy of them, and then they follow me, my blog, they watch my blog, they learn a lot to my blog, and then some of them, of my friends, we chat every time. They said, sir, can you help me to find a job, either land-based or sea-based? Because you know, there's a lot of Filipino in the overseas or the abroad, same like example, there's a lot of Filipino in Japan. Of course, I'm from Japan before 2007 until 2010, 3 years, and then after that, some of the Filipino or some of guy watching in me in my YouTube videos approach me and then ask to join our GC or group chat in Messenger, and then he said, sir, can you help me to join your GC or group chat in Messenger? I said to him, of course, why not? Everybody is welcome to my group, because that's what I'm trying to say to you, to everybody. You are welcome, because you know, you need the job. You have a family to feed, to support their needs, their foods, education, or maintenance of the drugs. When it comes to the, you know, there's a health problem of your family, I can support you, not financially, but for emotionally, okay, no problem. For the job, I teach you how to improve your skills, how to do the proper way, to change your life, to achieve your goal, your dreams, to become a successful welder, because the welder is special skilled in the world, very very special, the welder. All welders, you are watching right now and you are a welder, you are special. You are a fitter, you are watching right now. I'm tell you, my friend, you are very special skills in the whole mankind. You know what? Because the fitters, the welders, the machinists build everything. You know, I explain to you. You see the transportation, the bus, the jeepney, the taxi, who make that? Not only the machine, not only the engineers or the mechanical engineer or who build the ship, not only naval architect or engineers, not only a machine built by human, built by a person, built by a fitter, built by a welder. You know what I'm saying? Who build the buildings? Not only a machine, not only a crane, built by people, by manpower of the people, by built by construction worker, helper, laborer, scaffolder person, and then foreman, he also a person, he also before he come foreman, from the moment he apply his knowledge as a laborer and construction worker, and then he promote as a foreman. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of explanation about our skills. We build a lot of things. We build ship, we build building, we build buses, we build mining, we build train, we build deep well, offshore. You know, I'm trying to saying to you, you are special, my friend, so that all our people around the world, not only a Filipino, But a lot of people listening to me and watching to my video right now, what I'm trying to do, my friend, is we are one, okay? We don't like the any problem to me. I'm special, me, I'm very, very good, powerful, I'm very, very strong people, you know. In the ship, I'm a captain. In the ship, I'm a chief engineer. You need to follow me. I don't like that. Also, you don't want that, my friend. So what I'm trying to say is we need to follow the rules and regulation in the ship as a crew, because after 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, or 9 months maximum on our contract is finished, we are nothing, okay? We are contractual only. If you go to vacation, the ship, you leave the ship, okay? And then my relevo, okay, my reliever as a Peter is continue the job. So the job in the ship is not finished, cannot finish. The job is still continue until the ship or your vessel is scrapped, okay? You know, or sail to the another company. And then from the moment that the ship is built from shipyard, my friend, we cannot, I guarantee you, I'm sorry the English, okay? I guarantee to you, all of us as a welder, as a fitter, lot of job and opportunities we can find. Because every day, every week, every month, and every year, there's a lot of shipyard around the world, around the globe, especially Japan, Korea, okay, Dubai, they're building a lot of ship so that we can embark, or we can join, or we can job, or we can work in the ship. So we didn't have nothing to worry about it, okay? So I'm explaining to you now, so maybe this time to minimal my explanation to you, because this is my first time, as you can see, this is my first time vlogging in English version. You know, I hope you're listening to me and you understand to me, and then I tell you only good thing you can adapt to me. The bad thing you forget, because I'm not perfect, you are not perfect, we are not perfect at all. So that I'm sorry to tell you that this is my first time vlogging in English. So if you cannot understand my explanation or English as well, I'm very, very sorry, my friend. Okay, just forgive me, because what I'm trying to say here is explain in English so that everyone of you, especially in the foreign or Indian, especially, he requested to me also the other country that they cannot understand speak Tagalog, only action of the video. So I explain to you. So I need your comment down below. If you like my vlog today, my explanation in English, so I know there's a lot of need to improve my English language, okay? I know there's a lot of explanation I just want to do to you, explain to you next time. If you like or no like, just comment down below, and then I working on it. So that's it. I'm show you this video, and you can watch over and over again if you like. And if you have some comments, suggestion, I am welcome. You are welcome to comment. And if you want to reach me out, if you are an Indian foreign, and if you like to join our chat. But I tell you, no, the chat in our group is Tagalog, purely Tagalog. Only Kuya Andy or some of the officer in the group chat is not only ratings, you know. And telling you in the group chat, in the messengers that I have, is we have third engineer, we have electrician, we have second engineer also as well, not only high school graduate person, we have professional there. So that's why maybe if someone trying to join in the GC and then you started conversation in English, maybe that's the time to improve my GC, my channel, and my blog and my Facebook. So I'm happy to serve you and I'm happy to assist you. Just reach me out in my passenger. I put the job description in the job description, my cell phone number, so that you can approach me in WhatsApp, because my cell phone number is directly in my WhatsApp, also in my Messenger. I will put it in the description, in the link. I put it the link. I'm sorry. I'm rattled. I put it the link in the description so that you can follow me in Facebook. So, because you know, sometimes or every time anywhere in the Philippines, we only use every time a Facebook page and then a Messenger. Not every time we using WhatsApp, Viber, or Skype. We only using Messenger or Facebook in the Philippines. Also Instagrams sometimes, but I did not use Instagram because you know there's a lot of things I'm trying to do. I'm not focused in that. I'm focused in my job, my family, my also my motivational videos in our friends. So that's it. That video, you see the plunges, square plunges. I also recondition the what we call that square plunges also. I put it also the plants at the back so that you can put the chuck, because you know how can you put directly the square plunges. If you are a aspirant people, especially if you are a Filipino and you need to undergo a training, you need to improve your skills and knowledge, hit me up, message me in my WhatsApp 0919578110 and at Facebook, I have Facebook page Mandirigmang Marino TV or Team Mandirigmang Marino TV, and my Facebook page is Andy, Kuya Andy Vlogs, and Mandirigmang Marino TV. Comment down below, hit me up, reach me, and then I will assist you. Okay, I will assist you from the moment I have time, because you know I am on board right now. So I will reply to you and we changing conversation what I'm trying to do to you. For let's say you are a beginner and then you want to learn from me, from my group, I will add you in the GC, and then I teach you how to start training to take your Seaman's book, CERB or Seaman's book, and you want to get a late master certificate. I teach you when and where and how much the price. And then if you are listening to me right now and you are admire my video, you are every time watching my video, especially right now because I'm trying to say in English so you can understand me. So maybe next month or few months or another month from now, I started to release a new t-shirt or new design of my clothing line, Mandirigmang Marino Legacy, in social media. Of course, I will blog it to you from the moment I started to release this kind of clothing line. It is the t-shirt, the hoodie also as well. Hood, it means you can wear it in the daylight because I have a t-shirt, and then you can wear it in the winter or cold season because I will planning to release a jacket or hoodie. And then that's it from today, and then you can follow me, continue, and then I will upload my another video next time. Soon I will edit, and then trying to speak again English in my voiceover. So I'm sorry because this is not fluent English. This is my first time. Thank you very much. God bless you all, guys. You can. So that's why I put it also small plunges at the back, and then you can replace the front. So thank you for watching, guys, once again. Big salute to all of you, and if you have a question, comment down below and reach me out on my WhatsApp. More power to you. Keep safe on your job, on your work, on your ship. Safe sailing. God bless you all. Salute, Mandirigmang Marino, Kuya Andy. Let's go. Brrr.